All right, so good evening, everyone. My name is Jose Mendez. I'm a mechanical engineering junior, and I'm running to be the treasurer for next year. I want to start by talking about some of the key points that I feel a treasurer needs in order to be successful. The first is you need to be able to manage money, and the second is you need to have good communication skills. In terms of managing money, I have experience managing my own personal finance. For an example, currently I don't have a steady flow of income, but I do manage to save my money wherever I can and spend wisely so that I do have money to pay for any tuition that my financial aid doesn't cover, pay for gas, medical bills, things like that. In terms of communication, you need to be able, as a treasurer, to be able to talk to new members, because as the treasurer, you're the one that's collecting the dues from the new members. You need to be able to make new members feel welcome and at home here at Chef. And I have experience in ASME, where I am part of the recruitment committee. I've attended a Cougar Carnival and a Cat's Back, and I've helped recruit new members. So I know that as a treasurer, I'll be able to make the new members feel welcome, and they would want to stay here as Chef. And then some of the things I'd like to do as a treasurer, I'd like to make Chef more involved in terms of community, so that way we can give back, as well as be more involved with high schools in terms of outreach. And lastly, I'd want to help us develop our members professionally so that in career fairs and in national conference, Chef UH stands out to the employers. My name is Jose Mendez, and I hope you guys welcome me to the treasurer. Thank you.
Jose, as a treasurer, you have to be quite heavy attention to detail.
Right.
How many people were in this room?
I would say
So. Yeah, the mountain. How many are left-handed?
Left-handed? I would say 12.
How close was that?
I have one more question for the judges.
There are 5 people.
You talked about community. You have great communication skills. You talked about getting, you get talking to your members. So right. As a treasurer, you're responsible. So let's pretend pitch Chef to me so I could potentially donate money.
To donate money for us? Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Jose Mendez. So I'm part of Chef, and right now we're looking at doing community outreach events as well as participating in high schools, and we're looking for sponsorships. And what your company will benefit from is your logo would go on our sponsorship. It'd be free publicity for you. It'd also be beneficial for you to say, hey, our company's involved. We're giving back to community where there's Habitat, Houston Food Bank, things like that, as well as showing that you guys care about the high school students as much as we do. It'd also give us our members and your employers a good chance to interact together at the events, whether it's we go together to the Houston Food Bank and things like that. And I feel like both of us could benefit greatly from this partnership.
So what is Chef?
Chef, we're a society for Hispanic engineers. We promote, we try to develop our members professionally. That way we stand out whenever we're going to career fairs. We try to get them to be academically the best academic students possible. We try to get our chapter involved as much as possible, as well as about leadership, that way that our members are the leaders for the future.
Cool.
So one question from the audience, please. Let's give it to...
Okay, you said as a treasurer you want to help out Watership Junior and help our chapter go professionally. So what as a treasurer do you want to do to accomplish those goals?
For both of them? In terms of Chef Junior, I feel like we need to be involved with more than just... Like currently we're involved with just Reagan High School. And I feel like maybe we could do more than just Reagan High School. Try to open another Chef Junior chapter. That way, instead of maybe going to Reagan every 2 weeks or every week, maybe alternate, we're like, hey, we go to Reagan this week. Next week, let's go to this other high school. And that way, we keep it a little bit fresh. And in terms of professional development, I'd like to maybe work a little bit more with the professional chapter, the Houston professional chapter, see if we can build connections with them. That way they could like guide us into like what we need to do as professionals.
I have one question. So as a mechanical engineering student, I remember my junior year was terrible. You're taking your FEA, which is, that's your whole weekend. Machine design, which I believe Chang is going to teach it.
That's
She's
right.
going to make that class hard. You're taking D2, which Dr.
Dr. G,
he's going to kill you on that final. So, you know, your GPA is a 2.95. You're
right.
barely at a 3.0. You want to maintain that.
Right.
How are you going to manage three classes that are going to take a lot of time and also budget all of our events for the whole year? How are you going to manage that?
Right. Well, like, the 2.95, that was last semester. That's what brought it down. And that was a failure on my part for, like, time management. But this semester especially, I've seen that I've managed my time better and my GPA is going to come back up. And then I know with that experience that I've had, with that failure from last semester and then the improvement from this semester, I know that next semester with three classes and potentially a fourth where I'm still not sure what I'll be taking because of scheduling and because of just what's available to me, I feel that I'll be able to maintain those three classes as well as pay all the attention I need to on the treasury side.
Okay. All right. Let's give him a hand.